probably it's going to be edited out, I'm just going to say. Actually, it's not. It's going to be a raw footage. But our idea is to phone and into. Okay. Any ideas who we could interview? I know you say about Vodafone and stuff.
Yeah, but I think that's a bit too informal. Like, if he's going to the shop and asking them,
like you said, beforehand.
We could do that at all. So, what we have here is Vodafone and EA. What's the other one? Virgin, which at least three phone shops could do.
Who uses phones most?
Teenagers, but not for phone or apps and things.
Back it to my head. Yeah. So our target audience, the reason it's a dying trend,
yeah,
is because sooner or later we're going to go over.
Yeah.
We're teenagers as it is right now.
Yeah.
So we're going to go over what. So we interview teenagers.
Yeah.
Teenagers' parents. Who else can we interview? Talk of questions or something. Phone shop.
Yeah. And probably some old people as well, because they use the phone a lot. Like, yeah. Especially if they're lonely.
And they will be the ones using it for phone and not text.
Yeah.
So you've got the teenagers who text.
Yeah.
And then you've got the old people who phone.
Yeah.
And then the phone shop employees will have to be a bit of both. They will be in the middle.
Yeah.
If that's a line, they'll have to be in the middle,
yeah,
of the line.
Or if we have a standard idea, we could just go to any shop, like an office or business or whatever, because they'll use phones for business.
Yeah, but we'll have to organise that then.
Yeah.
At the moment, I'm having to do this for another unit, where you get people's signatures, so we need a lot of those.
Yeah.
I shouldn't be showing that. That's confidential. But that's the kind of thing we have to get is release forms as well.
Yeah. Just write a note to that.
You can put the notes on the PowerPoint.
Yeah.
We have to start the PowerPoint anyway. Looking weird, this video. You're writing notes and in the hot chocolate, can't look weirder. So parents will do a bit of both, won't they? Text and phone. So those two will interlink as their phone and text combination. You know for a fact, no one's going to go into a phone to say which one's better text than phone in. They'll have to be impartial. Their view will be very much impartial. But what's our narrative?
I don't know, that's where I struggle honestly with narrative in filmmaking.
What?
That's where I struggle with narrative.
Not really. What are we investigating? Is tech well, is phoning going out of date?
Yeah.
Is phoning going out of date? Everything we film either has to be for or against that point. So if someone says it's against it, we need to show at four points as well.
Observational.
Yeah. And maybe at the end we give our own view, but we need to make it impartial. And then at the end we say our own view.
We could probably interview some people with the class as well. Are you just like a fixed box pop thing to start off with?
That could be before a title sequence.
Yeah. Like, say you know before I put in our app, yeah, the phone, and then like go to an old person and hi, the phone.
The first thing we do is a quick box pop.
Yeah.
So with the class, we do a box pop, or we do it with people like Jamie and stuff, we ask them.
Yeah.
So instead of just going straight in, we have a pre-tagged sequence.
Yeah. And we have a narration.
That's a hard one.
Yeah.
Does that mean when we have the interviews of people, will they hear us? If you're doing vox pop, they will have to hear us.
What I'm thinking is, we might need to be in the race of the stars, you know, just like establishing.
Not really. Oh, what we could do. To introduce, we have vox pop, which should be people telling us.
Yeah.
Which then transitions into character sequence, which will be is text, is building going out of day, which then gets into the main thing.
Even that's probably a little bit better.
And then we get, then remember we've got to do the interview in 3 weeks, we've got to get the interview done in about 3 to 4 weeks. Who will we interview for that? We have to make it formal or informal.
Yeah. What I'm thinking is though, if we go into a phone shop, the lighting problem will never go with it. The lighting problem will be that one in the phone shop.
No. So what we can't do is go straight in this ask them.
Yeah.
Because first of all, we need permission to be on the premises.
Yeah.
Also, their permission to, we need a release form for that.
Yeah.
And then with that, we have to be careful where we film. That's the common documentaries, is everything has to be coordinated. So we need to get release forms where we're going to interview.
Yeah.
And then we need the location to be clear off.
But we know what happened last time with Shane Shortish. So, yeah.
What I mean is anything we ever do, main assignment, we'll need other location permission form to fill out. So it's well, it's not just into a film,
yeah.
It's we need release forms and a location permission form. Usually I'll do that maths, but I have a feeling, because we're going into a business room. There's more people. We could even into yourselves, but then
yeah.
that looks very suspicious that we can't
yeah.
left it in.
It kind of makes you look cheap as well. You're like,
that's what I've been realizing mine is all my play videos on me. So it's who? We can't have, we don't want to class in it yet.
Yeah.
But realistically, we need somebody major.
Yeah.
We need someone, but what we don't want to do is go straight in and get permission from the location.
Yeah.
Because we want to. Our thing has to be about 5 minutes. I was looking on the brief. At the moment, from looking at my notes, probably not yours, yours is probably more in detail than mine. Mine's just the key ones. We took out the class, the teenagers, the parents, the phone shop employees, and the old people, which is 5 people. Or more if we do the class. So straight away, we're hitting that 5 minute mark, and go over and get marked down.
I suppose people just want, like, they'll plan something else and just use what works best.
Yeah.
Because it's kind of, but I don't want to go over, you know, you don't want to go on, because then you'd have to do it all again and think about it.
The go under's fine. My opinion is
that
you can't go over, but to go under is perfect.
Yeah, okay.
I don't mean it in a way that we would definitely go under.
Yeah.
I don't mean it in that way. I mean,
no,
I know what I mean when I say that. Is,
yeah.
is I've done stuff that goes under, like my family, whether it's my family tree. And it's just scattering the shots you can get, waiting
yeah.
shots. We need to really think about what do you want to film. Bar into what else you want to show.
Some stock footage,
some phones, I don't know. We could try it out. Unless we get something out of Zoom, this idea is going to go basically down the drain.
We can't, you know, like we did the other week with the cars, just the observational thing. We could just like point the camera in the street and zoom and it leaves you using phone.
Oh, I hate Zoom.
Oh,
okay. No, that sounds like a negative.
No,
but that sounds really good.
Yeah.
It's just zoomed that out and zoomed that car out.
Just cut it. So like, we have the camera at speed, and if you see somebody talking on the phone, zoom it, we just use that bit. And like, if you see somebody texting, we just zoom and use that bit. So when you cut together, it's just like, I see it's close-ups, but other than the zooms.
I could do that.
Yeah.
Why we're talking about editing, who's going to edit and who's doing what?
I can't really do much like technical editing.
I'll do the editing.
Yeah.
Because I've got that idea of zooming in, I can just keep it on the street and I can zoom in using a box.
Yeah.
Like a, what is it, Ken Burns zoom.
Yeah, because I'm really not good at it. You've seen documentary after.
Just, mine was terrible, but what you'll see in my family one is I have a tendency towards going in. Instead of zooming in, I Ken Burns it in. So we oppose the zooming and we do a Ken, because the Ken Burns can just be quickly in and out.
Yeah.
That can be 5 seconds, and then back on the street it goes, using their quick dissolve. And why we do that actually, while we're on that, we could actually have two cameras.
Yeah.
And basically each person that's texting or phoning,
yeah,
we do a box pop for them. And basically that box is the interview. We're trying to target these people. So, but what we're actually doing is we're basically a box pop. But we still need it for an informal interview. But the problem with that is we're not actually going to use it, are we? We're going to be observing it and then doing an interview with the person. But then what I would have to make sure I have with me on that day is lots and lots of these.
Yeah, I was just going to say, we'd probably say about 50 just in case.
50?
Well, you never know.
How long do you expect us to be there? I'm sorry, but...
No, okay, not 50.
Definitely not 50.
No.
I found 10 of those out this morning, and Ed saw me do that, I'm pretty sure. A bit over 10. Definitely not. Maybe 15.
Yeah.
But what we have to keep in consideration is it's only 5 minutes. So it can't... So I'm actually thinking 5 people. 4/5 people.
Yeah.
4/5 people. And we see... And we talk to them. Because I've seen a one where what she's Dean did. And he had 5 people with each of the 3 different questions. So what we'd have to do then is we have to structure the 3 questions. One could be, we don't need any names. All we need is them to sign that. We don't need the names. Actually, if we get the names, I can put a little title at the end.
Thank you thing.
Yeah, and when they talk, we have like a little box that comes underneath saying, for example, Ezekiel Jones, punching parent of 5.
Yeah.
Not that I'm saying that person is a parent of 5. Might just work a bit better than trying to go into a phone shop, talking to the person, and then you can't film in here, lad.
Yeah. Unless you go ahead and just like do quick survey or email.
You do it. I know we could do that.
Yeah.
Still a lot of consideration. Yeah, but then again, we have to make sure it's the right person we're emailing. If you send it to the wrong email, Vodafone, we're going to get permission to do it in London.
Yeah.
Not where we are now.
I mean, I imagine they have like an individual email for each store.
Yeah.
Oh, at the very least, phone number.
I don't even know where these phone shops are in Preston.
They're quite a town by new train station. So they're kind of going a bit out of the city centre.
They're near the train station?
Yeah.
That's fine by me.
Yeah.
That's where my bus gets in. Only place I could think about was where in Southport there's a chap house that's in the garden.
Yeah.
There you go. Thank you. the way to pop in.
Yeah.
Then they want dates when we're gonna film.
Yeah.
And it's just, and it isn't until due like the 27th of April or something. That leaves us about 2 months to do it. So we've got the idea of the box pop.
Yeah.
Of course that's my opinion. Very shocking toys you have to arrange and organise. I'm not going to try and make friends with them, I don't drink. I don't know how much Ed drinks or how drunk he is when he actually does. There's meeting greets with the people. There's no chance we're doing that.
Yeah.
I just have to arrange it and organise it that way.
Yeah.
And if we can't get a location, we'll try and get someone from the phone shop to come here. And I can book M210 out. We film it in there. You haven't got Facebook, have you?
No, I've got an email.
No, that's not what I'm suggesting.
Oh, sorry.
I'm suggesting. That's what I call Facebook apps. Which would be a status basically asking people. Probably not. It's the idea.
Yeah.
But we need to know when we want to start filming and our ideas and all the pre-production planning.
Yeah.
All the release forms we have to. I'll have to redo a whole release form.
Yeah.
And try and organise it that way. It's gonna take a lot. Got a lot of time before we can run.
Yeah.
We have to walk first. So. What I suggest we do is we meet every 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Maybe 15 minutes before a lesson.
Yeah.
Because this is like the general meeting, and then we'll know what we're getting on to.
Yeah.
So what we should do now with the target for next meeting.
Yeah, well, that's what they said. They were like, although just like, you're like, your shit, we're putting down
this episode,
and you're
going to be. So what are we trying to get done for next meeting?
Well, then just a PowerPoint has to be in by
same kind of time as
yeah. So it's all by the end of April.
Yeah, but we don't do it. This is our next meeting, which will be 2 weeks today.
Right, okay.
We meet every 2 weeks to make sure our progress is going steady.
Yeah.
And then during half term, edit them and talk to them.
Yeah.
If we aim to film the half term.
Yeah.
The target. The main target is.
Should I have everything ready to fill back up?
Leaving the editor, me, 3 weeks to edit.
Yeah.
It shouldn't be too hard. You just don't get the excess footage.
Well, then when we know
it. All we have to do now is hope Ed gets us some help. Next meeting will be our pitch. So we have to know the idea very well.
Yeah.
We have to do it inside now. That's mainly it, really. Because when we have to do the pitch, do you want a PowerPoint or not?
I can do a PowerPoint, yeah.
Okay, you know my email address, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, so do it that way then. If you don't know my email address, text me and I'll text you it.
Yeah.
But if we email, use a OneDrive or whatever other online thing there is, then you send it over to me. We're both working, we both check it and make sure it's all right.
Yeah.
And then we use that PowerPoint for the pitch. But if we defer a video with this, pretty much shit sorted.
And do we have to show that SVT cover and things, or we need to go to the end?
We have to do that?
Yeah. It will be. We have to design like a poster image or that. But to be honest, I think we're not going to leave that until the end, because it's not really up to
the point. Is it barely on the
list?
I'm not. because I have not seen it on there.
I think it's hidden away in like some other thing.
What?
I think it's hidden away in like some other details.
I know what I want Moses to look like.
Yeah.
A phone. Pretty much
yeah.
That. It's just a silly image of a phone. Isn't that too fancy? A post design is purely a phone. A phone like that.
Yeah, and then like with a text on it. Yeah.
Or ringing. This is like text. And the title of the documentary will be Phone. Or Phone Home. Do it that way. Poster. This creates some vista. And then the title of the documentary. So you go in, see it's Phone Home, it's currently gone out of date. That's basically our synopsis is. That's pretty much our poster.
Yeah.
It's a synopsis.
I think teens have got a lot of work
to go. So is that it for today?
Yeah, I think we've
done enough. Okay, yeah. I want to get some details.
Yeah.
And I've got to get some more of these stories. I'll send it off to...